Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year!
On the solemnity of the circumcision of our Lord, let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say to our fathers, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. This is my covenant with you and your descendants after you that you must keep. Every male among you shall be circumcised.
I will not violate my covenant, the promise of my lips. I will not alter. By my holiness, I swore once for all.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, Your blessed Son was circumcised in observance of your ancient law, so that we might enter into the glorious freedom of the children of God. Cleanse our hearts by an inward circumcision from all incentives to sin, that we may worship you in spirit and in truth. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from the book of Genesis. God said to Abraham, "For your part, you and your descendants after you must keep my covenant throughout the ages. This is the covenant between me and your descendants after you that you must keep. Every male among you shall be circumcised. Circumcise the flesh of your foreskin. That will be the sign of the covenant between me and you. Throughout the ages, every male among you, when he is 8 days old, shall be circumcised, including houseborn slaves and those acquired with money from any foreigner who is not of your descendants. Yes, both the houseborn slaves and those acquired with money must be circumcised. Thus, my covenant will be in your flesh as an everlasting covenant. If a male is uncircumcised, that is, if the flesh of his foreskin has not been cut away, such a one will be cut off from his people. He has broken my covenant." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing my soul.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing my soul.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing my soul.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing my soul.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The statutes of the Lord are true, all of them just.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing my soul.
More desirable than gold, than a hoard of purest gold, sweeter also than honey or drippings from the comb.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing my soul.
The second reading is from the book of St. Paul to the Galatians. "Once again, I declare to every man who has himself circumcised that he is bound to observe the entire law. You are separated from Christ, you who are trying to be justified by law. You have fallen from grace. For through the Spirit, by faith, we await the hope of righteousness. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision or uncircumcision counts for anything, but only faith working through love." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. For we are the circumcision, we who worship through the Spirit of God, who boast in Christ Jesus and do not put our confidence in flesh. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. This is the gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, on the first day of the year, New Year's Day, thankfully we have the shortest gospel reading in the entire year. I think we can all appreciate that. But it's important that we celebrate the solemnity today, because Jesus being circumcised was him being initiated into the Abrahamic covenant that we heard about in Genesis. And he became a part of the chosen people that he was born into from the house of David. But also he calls us to circumcise our hearts, our souls, to take out those things that shouldn't be there, that cause us to sin. And we celebrate that within the octave of Christmas. And speaking of that, I'm sure we're all familiar with the 12 days of Christmas, the carol, right? Now, it may just seem to be 12 random things that just seem to be thrown together, but actually there's a lot more to it, and it's actually very theological. In fact, it was written in the 6th century by a group of clerics, or priests and deacons, to help teach the faith, and was set to music in England in the 18th century. And what I'd like to do is go over these with you, so next time you hear it, even though it's kind of annoyingly repeated, you have in your mind what exactly is being talked about. The first day, we have the partridge in the pear tree. Now the partridge, of course, is Jesus. And the partridge is the only bird that will die to protect its young. Very appropriate. But why a pear tree? Well, if we look at a very pregnant woman on a profile, can I see a pear, right? So the partridge in a pear tree is Jesus in the womb of Mary being born unto us. Two turtle doves. What could that be? Well, that's the Old and the New Testaments. And within those, we have God's complete plan for the entire world and its history. Three French hens. Well, these represent the theological virtues of faith, hope, and love. We find that in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Fourth day, four calling birds. Well, this is probably pretty simple to figure out. It's the four gospel writers, Mark, Matthew, Luke, and John. Five golden rings. Well, those are the first five books of the Old Testament, known as the Torah or Pentateuch. Six geese a-laying. Well, that goes back to the very first story in Genesis, the 6 days of creation. Seven swans a-swimming. Now, this one's a little bit tougher to get out, but these represent the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, which are prophecy, ministry, teaching, exhortation, giving, leading, and compassion. eighth day. That's actually the day we're in right now, by the way. That's eight maids a-milking. Now that is, well, firstly, the milkmaids were considered the lowest in ancient England, the lowest of the low. And it's kind of like being a shepherd back in Jesus' day. But these are the eight Beatitudes that Jesus preached on the Sermon on the Mount. Blessed are the poor in spirit, those who mourn, so on and so forth. Nine ladies dancing? Well, these are the fruits of the Holy Spirit, which are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Tenth day, ten lords a-leaping. Well, this one is the Ten Commandments. 11 pipers piping. Now, what would we have? It would be 11. It's kind of a trick because it's the 11 apostles who did not betray Jesus. Finally, the 12 drummers drumming. That one are the 12 points of doctrine within the creed that we have. So perhaps the next time we hear the song, we'll now know exactly what's being said, be it by the Muppets or whoever. But that brings us back to this beautiful solemnity of the circumcision, because that first day is always Jesus and Mary. And Mary and Joseph brought Jesus to be brought in to that beautiful Abrahamic covenant so that he was part of the chosen people. And then, from there, saved not only the Israelites, but all of humankind forever onward. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Trusting in God's love and faithfulness, let us bring our petitions now before him, and our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may continue to grow and flourish under the aid of our Blessed Mother, who shows us the way to her Son, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and holy marriages here at Holy Trinity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, that inspired by the newborn Christ, we may welcome the challenges of the new year with courage and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, especially those on our parish prayer list, that they may find strength and healing by turning to Jesus who heals us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions we hold deep in the silence of our hearts. And the particular intention for whom this Mass is offered, for Holy Trinity Parish. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased loved ones and those who will die today, that they may be clothed in the light of Christ's love for all eternity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, as we begin this new year, open our hearts and minds to the many blessings you offer and give us joy in following your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
One is not a Jew outwardly. True circumcision is not outward in the flesh. Rather, one is a Jew inwardly, and circumcision is of the heart in the spirit, not the letter. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation through goodness, when I spread the offer which earth has given human hands have made. May it become for us the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. Share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation through goodness, us wine to offer fruit of thy work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless this sacrifice which we have prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the passion, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, Lord, our prayers and our gifts. Hear us in your mercy, and by these mysteries cleanse us. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. In fulfillment of the ancient covenant of Abraham, 8 days after his birth, Jesus was circumcised and thereby is a true son of Abraham and son of David. In Christ, this covenant changed from a circumcision of the flesh to one of the spirit. We are now a people circumcised in heart and spirit, worshiping through the very Spirit of God in the unity of Christ who is all in all. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, We lift a hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 5, which is found on page 92 if you're following along. Blessed are you, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercy and God of all consolation. For you so loved the world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He then established a lasting memorial of your salvation. On the evening in which he willingly surrendered himself, he took bread, gave you thanks, blessed it, and broke it, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." When supper had ended, he took the cup. In the same way, he gave you thanks and blessed it, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." So we recall before you, Father, the incarnation of your Son, his words and deeds, how he humbled himself and obediently accepted death, even death on the cross. Therefore, you have raised him up and given him a name which is above every name, so that in heaven and under the earth, every knee shall bow and every tongue proclaim to the glory of God the Father, Jesus Christ is Lord. We offer the sacrifice of your Son before you, Father, with praise and thanksgiving, and ask that you accept this oblation. Send your Holy Spirit and fill these gifts with his life-giving power, that they may be for us the body and blood of your dearly beloved Son. Grant that the bread which we break may be the body of our Lord, and the cup over which we give thanks may be one with the blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. The company of Mary, the Mother of God, with your apostles and martyrs, Holy Willibrord, and all the saints, together with Anthony, our prime bishop, and Jerry, our bishop, and with all bishops, priests, and deacons, as well as your whole church, we praise and glorify you and look forward to the coming of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Page 95. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power,
cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because there is one bread. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread. May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's now offer each other a Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Let us say together the First Communion prayer found on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online or who for personal reasons cannot receive the Eucharist today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Here, there is not Greek and Jew, circumcision and uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, but Christ is all and in all. Let us pray. With your watchful tenderness, Lord, guard the hearts which have been made holy by these sacred mysteries, and awaken them to a greater love for you, our first beginning and final goal. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Guard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. It is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for our Holy Mass today. Pray that you have a wonderful day, a very happy new year. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other. Remain in a state of grace, fight evil, and spread joy wherever you may find it.
Proclaim Christ is born in Bethlehem.